The exhaust pipe fell off.
Hello and welcome back. We're out here camping. I'm not gonna tell you where. We found this beautiful shore diving spot right here at the ocean, and it's open to spearfishing. We came fairly late last night so that it was already kind of getting dark, and we just enjoyed the evening. My new job requires me to work on weekends a lot, and yeah, now we're here. I have the weekend off. I'm really excited. We're trying to make the best out of it. Let's check it out. I have like really, really, really low expectations, but maybe, just maybe, I'm gonna be able to shoot my first ever lingcod. Thanks for joining me on the water today. Visibility is looking pretty good for the summer months. There are lots of sediments in the water column, but I would say it's still decent. So as I said earlier, I'm going to be looking for lingcod here. This video is from back in summer, where regulations for lingcod and rockfish were still open. In my area, the legal size minimum for lingcod is 65 centimeters, and you can harvest one per day. For rockfish, there's no size limit, but you can also only harvest one per day. If you go spearfishing, make sure to take a good look at regulations. Regulations can vary a lot in the different areas. For example, if you compare the west coast of Vancouver Island with the east coast of Vancouver Island. I was only allowed one rockfish per day, and at the west coast you can have three per day, but only one of them can be a shiner, tiger or quillback rockfish. Let's be responsible and always inform ourselves before we go. If somebody gets caught poaching, it's going to reflect on all of us. Spearfishing might be the most sustainable way of harvesting fish, but sometimes we make mistakes. On this day, for some reason, my accuracy was really off. And in this case, I shot too high and injured the fish slightly. I absolutely hate that this has happened and feel really bad about it. I think the fish will be fine, as it's not a severe injury, but it still makes me really upset. I tried relocating the fish for a few dives and thought it would be this one here, but I couldn't find it.
This has got to be the biggest sturgeon I've ever seen.
And this lingcod here is pretty damn close to legal. As I previously said, I was just not having it that day, and I still don't know how this shot didn't tear out. I quickly dispatch and bleed the fish, and now look at the tiny piece of skin it's been holding onto. This is a copper rockfish on the smaller side. I try not to shoot any rockfish smaller than this. Enough rambling about fish. Let's enjoy these last clips. I think the spot has a lot of potential if you look at the amount of juvenile lingcod in this video. And it definitely needs a bit more exploring. I'm very certain that there is a legal sized lingcod waiting down there for me somewhere. If you hit that subscribe button and turn on the notifications for my channel, you will be notified when I upload the whole video where I finally get my first lingcod. And as always, thank you for the support, I hope you liked the video. Please leave me a thumbs up or a comment with feedback or questions.
So, we're back and we're just chilling with a view and with snacks, all we need. Watching. It's gonna be the shortest video in the history of my YouTube channel, I think. Bye!